Welcome to NareSai Technologies. This is Ram Chandar. In this video, I'm going to discuss about programming points related to java.util.hashmap. So, our concept is program on java.util.hashmap in Java Collection Framework. Now, according to previous video, lot of information I given related to hashmap and its functionalities. So those functionalities, nothing but those information I want to provide programmatically. I want to explain by using one program. Now here I'm creating hashmap hm equal to new hashmap. Now it is available in java.util package. Yes, I'm importing that. Now observe here in list implementation classes, not only list, collection implementation classes, if you want to add the data into container objects, we are using three methods like add, push and offer. But especially if you want to add the elements into the hash map, we are using the method like what? Put. So put having two parameters, one is represents for key, another one is what? Value. Now here I'm writing like 101 RAM, 101 RAM. Second one is 102 SAM. Now I told you in the previous video, it will allows homogeneous objects. So insertion always depend upon what? Keys. Based on the keys only, data is going to place it into the hash map. For example, how many objects I added? Two objects I added only two objects. Yes, what? One is 101, another one is what? 102. Now whenever I talks about, it will allow a heterogeneous also. Heterogeneous means here we can able to add a heterogeneous keys or also heterogeneous values. Now here I'm writing like 103. Initially my keys are what here, 101, 102, both are same, but both are same means what here, both are belongs to java.lang.integer. Now this is what java.lang.string, we can able to enter heterogeneous objects as a key in the hash map. Now I told you like it will allows different type of data like true, and I'm writing like null, and hm.put false, hm.put false as well as null. So boolean we can use as a key of the hash map. See, false null as well as true null. So we can write duplicate values, but we can't write what here, duplicate keys. For example, I'm writing like hm.put 101, and this is what here, Kiran. This is what here, Kiran. Now, very simple. Let me copy this code, and before Kiran, what I'm doing, again, I'm printing the hash map related data. Now, 101 RAM, now replace it with what here, 101 Kiran. So if you observe, is there any 101? No, that means it will not allow the duplicate keys, but it will allow what here, duplicate values. So if you are adding duplicate keys, old data will be replaced with what here, new data. For example, here I'm writing like hm.put 103, again I'm writing like what here, Kiran, again I'm writing like what here, Kiran, like a string object. Then what happened? Happily, Kiran will be available two times, 101 as well as what here, 103, 101 as well as what, 103. It will allows what here, duplicate, okay, it is allows duplicate values but not a case. Now let me write null as a key. Null as a key, can we able? Let's check. Null, here I'm writing like what here, Mahi, and one more null I'm adding, hm.put null, I'm writing like what, Ravi. So like this, I'm adding different types of elements. Yes, null Mahi and null Ravi. So how many times null values are available? Only one time as a first element. So null Mahi will replace it with what here? Ravi. Then automatically this hash map capacity is what here? 16. Whenever we adding a 13th element, automatically it going to be double. So whether it is going to be double or not, that we will see in the next video. Now, and it is implement serializable, clonable. It will implement serializable, clonable as well as map. Okay. Now let's check order is not preserved. Let's check order is not preserved here. First 101 I added, it will be placed into second index, and null I'm added last, but it will be placed at what here? First. So based on some hashing, the data will be placed into different order. Okay, so how the data will be placed into different order, how it will find out the index position, that we will see in also next video. In the next video, the main intention is how elements are placing into different index positions, whether the hash map is growable in nature or not. Okay, so first my intention is only one thing in this video. I want to add some elements, and as well as I want to print individually. If you want to print individually of any container object, literally we are using always three cursor objects like enumeration, iterator, list iterator, like that. So let me check, can we able to apply enumeration or not? If you clearly observe, there is a method like get contains entry set, key set, remove. So everything is different means it will returns what your different types of return types. For example, hash map return type is object, here return type is boolean, here different types of what here, it return type is set, object, boolean, int, object, void, object. So return types are always objects most of the cases, and boolean and void and int, see like this. But we don't have return types like enumeration, we don't have return types like what here iterator, we don't have return types like what here list iterator. That means we can't apply these things directly on the hash map. Then how can we print the data, sir? See, basically there are three ways to print hash map related data. There are three ways to print hash map related information. So first one is entry format. Second one is only key format. And third one is key and value separately. Again, there are three types. Now first let me go with the entry format. Now how to develop entry format? First we need to read the data in the form of entry. Entry means what? The combination of key and value. For reading the data in the form of entry, there is a method like what here? Entry set. Yes, the return type is what here? Set only. The return type is what here? Set. Set s equal to entry dot set. Now we can apply enumeration, iterator, list iterator on top of what here? Set. There are methods like iterator I equal to s dot iterator. Now lot of videos I given related to iterator in the Java collection framework. If you don't know about the iterator, please go through my previous videos related to cursor objects in Java collection framework. Now I dot has next, it check whether the element is existed or not. Whether the element is existed, then we can able to print the data. How I dot next, see individually, see each and every key and value separately printed, each and every key and value combination separately printed, nothing but entry wise everything will be printed. Now I want to print only keys. How can we, sir? Very simple. Let me take a set s1 equal to hm dot key set. Now again I'm taking like a iterator I1 equal to s1 dot iterator. Now I'm going to navigating the data of iterator, like i1.hasNext. i1.hasNext. Now here I'm printing like i1.next. Now what happened? Only keys will be available in the variable set s1. Only keys will be stored in the s1. Here key and value will be stored in the s, and here only keys will be stored in the s. Now we can print value and key separately. How can we observe? First we need to read the data in the form of set, nothing but in the form of entry, in the form of entry. Later what I'm doing, I'm creating iterator implementation class object, iterator i2 equal to s2 dot iterator. Okay, now observe here, while i2 dot has next, I'm checking whether the element is available or not. If available, I want to hold the data by using what here, map dot entry. So map dot entry is the inner interface of map, which is useful for representing what entries, nothing but key and value combinations. Now here I written like i2 dot next. It will asking to casting nothing but map dot entry here. Yes, here I'm writing like entry. Good. Now in the ME, nothing but in the entry interface, there is a method like get key, and what is that, get key, as well as what here, there is a method like ME dot get value, get key as well as what here, ME dot get value. Now what happened? Every information will be printed. These are key and values. Let me give more clarity in the output. System dot out dot println keys / t values. Escape character should be in small letters. Yeah, now observe. So keys are what here, null 101, false 102 Yani, and values are Ravi, Kiran, null, Sam, 123, Kiran, null. So what is the meaning here is, first we are reading the data in the form of entry that will be placed into s2, nothing but in the form of set object. After that we are placing the data into iterator for navigating each and every entries individually. So first I read here one entry, after that I converted into map.entry format, and for by using map.entry interface methods we are printing what here individually. There are totally three ways: key and value separately, here only keys, and here entries wise. So like this there are three ways to print the hash map related data. I hope you understand this video. For more videos, please subscribe Naresh IT channel. Thank you.